The following program is rated TV-MANOC. It contains a big pair of nuts directly on your chin. It is intended only for mature audiences. Viewer discretion advised. What's going on, fam? It's your boy, Papa Swolio, with some more nuts on your chin. Now, you all know I got two nuts, but I also just put in battery lettered D into my camera, and I'm gonna give you some D on this video. This was brought to my attention just today, and it happened within the last day or two, and I've had this name sent to me before to make a video, but I get a lot of things sent to me. I got a lot of stuff on my plate. I got a lot of things to put my nuts on. Here is another example of when fitness or personalities and influencing in general online goes horrifically wrong. This is one of the benefits and the downsides of social media because we all are so connected. We can bring attention to so many things. We can promote what we enjoy. We can promote our passions. We can sell products. We can create businesses. But what social media also does is expose the bullshit in the industry. It exposes people because there's so much attention and there's so many people observing what people do. There are a lot of people observing what I do. There are people observing what everyone does, especially when you are someone like Trisha Paytas. Trisha Paytas, when you're someone that has millions of subscribers. Now, Trisha Paytas has 1.3 million subscribers on YouTube and 2.6 million subscribers on Instagram. So this is Brittany Dawn Fitness times like six or seven. I am not going to do the math. Now, you might be asking, why am I bringing up Brittany Dawn? Well, because Trisha is fucking bringing up Brittany Dawn. Trisha, this person, according to her Instagram profile, she is, quote, just another dumb blonde. With a brain. I just left a little extra long pause just for some flavor. Her profile is nauseating, but that's my opinion. The picture that's in question is this one that she posted 3 days ago, and it shows it's an ad. She put the hashtag ad, and she did put paid partnership, so I guess points for that aspect. But it's for this company called BoomBod, which apparently is some garbage weight loss supplement, like all of them are. That is not how you lose weight. That's not how you are healthy. That's not how you are actually supposed to go through the weight loss process. So right off the bat, this is another garbage product that no one should use that's actually interested in losing weight healthily and properly. She goes on to say, I am so proud of the progress I've made, and BoomBod has been there every step of the way. This stuff is packed with vitamins, uses a clinically, she can't spell that well, use a clinically proven natural fiber, contain zero laxatives, and most importantly, it really works. They've got up to 50% off right now at BoomBod.com. So aside from the choppy grammar, which always just pisses me off, it's just like, if you're gonna push something that's a load of crap, at least spell it correctly and use proper grammar. She got lit up in the comments because she's been promoting shit like this or this product. I did not go deep and research all of this because the video that I watched and the couple things I look at, it's so nauseating to me. I just do not want to expose my eye holes to this. There's not much to research. This is just another example of someone that is using insane popularity for whatever reason and to push garbage supplements. Obviously, it's a paid sponsorship, but this is something that is dangerous for people's health. And people in the comments are lighting her up, stop promoting shit, way to use a pre-lipo picture before, because her picture is before she had liposuction. And the picture on the left is extremely, extremely old. Everyone looks different from a picture that was years and years and years old. I look different than a picture that I took when I was 26 too. I look completely different because I'm an older adult male. You're an older adult female now. Of course you're gonna look different. Everything is different from the before and after picture. Was the picture on the left taken before you had weight loss surgery to help you lose weight with no aid from the product you're promoting? Scammy legend, Brazilian butt lift, liposuction, breast augmentation and lift. I love you, Trish, but this type of marketing is part of the reason you yourself have so many body image issues. Congrats on passing it on to generations of girls to come. This is extremely bad in itself. It's really bad. It's someone with more influence. It's someone with a bigger following. It's someone that has just more eyes on her that is promoting garbage advice and very, very dangerous advice. These products are not safe. These products are not healthy. These products are not good for you. And let alone from people's perceptions or ideas or opinions on lipo and all those things, it's being completely dishonest. Dare I say, a scam. Which brings us to the main purpose of this video. It's her apology video titled Coming Clean About My Scamming. And in this video, she talks about what a scam is and how what she did or what she does isn't a scam. She didn't address this exact issue because I could only watch the beginning portion because the video is so cringe. Plus, it's 40 minutes long and I have so many better things to do with my time. So if you want to go through and watch the whole thing, my goodness, the first minute is just like, I just felt myself asphyxiating. I literally felt just brain cells saying, fuck this, I'm out. And right now I'm filming this. I was about to go to the gym when I got alerted for this. So I'm a little bit pissed off because this is taking time away from me getting my pump on. So thanks, Trish. What she does in this video is tell everyone that what she does and has been doing is not a scam. She calls out Brittany Dawn saying, what that girl, I believe it was Brittany Dawn Fitness, she made custom programs and then didn't deliver. A scam is when you say you're going to deliver a product and you don't deliver a product.
Y'all need to know what a scam means. Okay, because I saw another, well, I didn't see the video. I don't watch it. But another person was like, she's scamming her fans for that money. Like, a scam is something like if you pay for a service and that person doesn't follow through. It's like there was a girl recently on YouTube who did like fitness, custom fitness plans. But like they weren't custom and she just gave a generic one to everybody. That's, I mean, that is more of a scam if you're promising like, hey, okay, like you get, that would be like, okay.
You unlock this door with the key of imagination.
This is from Merriam-Webster. Definition of a scam, a fraudulent or deceptive act or operation. Would you call putting a before and after a before picture that's very, very old, before liposuction, and putting an after when you're sucking in your stomach, smiling, tan, with your shirt off, with your top off, holding a product saying, you can save 50% off now, this is amazing, I lost all this weight using this product. Would you consider that deception? Would you consider showing someone and telling them, look, I use this product, look at all this weight I've lost, you can lose weight too, buy this product, but that's not how you lost the weight? That's not how you improved your health or lost body fat. That's not at all what that product actually does. It won't work for you. Would you call that deception? Fuck yeah, you would. It's absolutely deception. It's an absolutely fraudulent or deceptive act. I believe giving people false information, lying to people about before and afters, and doing so to sell a product, I believe that classifies as a scam. Offering up results and giving people the tools that will not get them the results, that's not delivering. You're delivering someone some kind of bullshit supplement to get them the results that you're showing, but it won't give them that result. It won't help them achieve that. That is a scam. Did you obtain money by promoting BoomBod? Yes, you received money then as part of your deception. That's what a scam is. And let's not nitpick at the semantics. Let's say you couldn't define this as a technical scam. It's still being a piece of shit. It's still doing something wrong. It's still lying to people. If you're fucking lying to people, you're doing something dishonest. You're not being a good person. You're lying. 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 You are lying to people. I'm so proud of the progress I've made, and BoomBod has been there every step of the way. No, your lipo and your surgeries have been there every step of the way. I mean, this chick's channel is a hot fucking nightmare. Her videos have titles like the following. I passed out at the gym, parentheses, why you shouldn't starve yourself. Lost 20 pounds in 2 weeks. Eating alone in the Arby's parking lot. Girl, you need some serious freaking help. You need some serious help. P period, if you are finding yourself in an Arby's parking lot and your car didn't break down. This girl absolutely scammed people. And when you make a response video to your so-called scam and you're trying to protect yourself, it doesn't need to be 40 fucking minutes long if you're telling the truth. We're at a very interesting time, people, when you cannot hide from your lies. If you're gonna put out content on the internet, you better damn well be honest with your subscribers. You better damn well tell the fucking truth. At least be honest about it. And don't try to skirt around little definitions. This is absolutely a scam. It's absolutely a deceptive act, which is the definition of a scam. And if you are not guilty, you do not need a 40-minute YouTube video to defend yourself.
We go from humble to flexing. You DM, I'm texting. She hit me right back. I'm on the move. I'm not stressing. A king to these peasants. You know that's a fact. Y'all hate the press. Y'all elect them. A press for 11. I gave them a stack. I use these words as my weapon. A demon obsession. We killing the pack. We go from humble to flexing. You DM, I'm texting. She hit me right back. I'm on the move. I'm not stressing. A king to